It's just brilliant just to live here and be at one with nature.
Hello, my name's Debs, and I currently live in one of the smallest detached houses in the UK. So just over 20 years ago, well, 2000, we were driving past Tadcaster and we noticed for sale in this beautiful estate, and we came to have a look at this place. It's tiny, it's gorgeous, it has got the most fantastic views, and we couldn't resist it, especially not when it's freehold. So we've been in the property since February 2000, and I think we paid around about £80,000 for it when we actually moved in. Done a lot of work on it. It had things that needed replacing. We've had a completely new rewiring within the last year, and we've done the garden, as you can see, is absolutely gorgeous. So we've now got it on the market for £235,000, which is an absolute snip when you see the views that you actually get. It's not a little house you're buying, it's actually a way of life, a lifestyle in a country park, which is totally private to everybody else. So one of the major things when we actually moved in was arranging insurance. So obviously everybody has to get house insurance, and one of the questions they ask is, what is your roof made of? Now, when you say the roof is stepped lead, but you have a stone king kneeling on the top with his sword drawn, then they don't really believe you that much. So when anybody actually asks me where I live, I say I live a stone throw from Tadcaster, just near the A64, 20 minutes from York, but actually in the most beautiful country setting, which blows people away when they come here. The actual road links to Leeds and York are 5 minutes away, but sitting here on an evening, you've got owls, you've got deers, you've got all the wildlife, and it is just absolutely incredibly amazing. So this is a Grade 2 listed property. It sounds tiny, because what you can see is the actual bedroom, and that's around about 8 foot by 10 foot, but it is a double level, so you've got a mezzanine in there as well. But then we actually go underground, which is really unusual, with a beautiful sunken courtyard, a vaulted bathroom, and a nice glass roof above where you sit. So the house itself, it's got spiral staircases, which take sometimes a little bit of getting used to, but once you get used to them, you can run up and down them like anybody's business. You've also got a spiral staircase up to your sleeping platform, which is a little bit unusual, I think. The house itself has got, I don't think, any like rectangles. There's no squares whatsoever. It is just so quirky inside. We've even got a chandelier in the kitchen, which is slightly odd, I think. But to be quite honest, when you make your coffee, you walk out to the courtyard, sit down, and you're surrounded by blue tits and woodpeckers and all the noises from the country. It doesn't matter what the house actually is like, and the fact that it's a nightmare to wallpaper, it's just brilliant just to live here and be at one with nature. So we are actually selling up. Some lucky person's going to be living here, like we have for the last 20 odd years. And we have various things that you have to get used to, like you have the hunt. We have Bramman Hunt goes from here. We have next door actually have planning permission for underground, so there's no reason why you wouldn't get it, and they're happy to share their plans. And they're having a swimming pool and a lounge and another bedroom totally under the lawns, and you can see how big that's going to be when you can use all of this space. The other things we have here, there is a chute, we have lots of pheasants and partridges, things like that. They also do what are called simulated shoots, which is your clay pigeon shooting. So there's loads going on. It's very country pursuits. And to be quite honest, I can see why there was some kings that came and stayed here, because it is the place to be.